The minister identified these programs as integrated community case management, constituency health task forces, public health protocols, and piloting of integrated HIV, malaria, hepatitis B, and other common illnesses.
Health service delivery is not the delivery that would have wanted within the sub-district. We also realize that many people who come here, who follow sick to come to these health units, are actually not very sick. They are coming because of preventable illnesses. Illnesses that could have been prevented if we had strong community health programs.
This is expected to be an effective strategy in the promotion of health and prevention, as well as the treatment of common diseases for children under the age of 5.
The integrated community case management of malaria, pneumonia, and diarrhea will be rolled out to the country starting next week.
The rolling out of these programs will be possible after the Global Fund doled out a $4.6 billion grant.
There's no other country that had done this, that had got a grant from Global Fund to support community health workers or village health teams to go in the villages from the comfort of people's homes and treat for and manage malaria, pneumonia, as well as diarrhea.
The ministry is also set to form constituency health task forces, which are expected to be established in all districts to enable stakeholders dialogue and exchange of views on health.
All the 238 health sub-districts or constituencies are going to establish these task forces in order to improve the equity and access to health care services.
Dr. Tumwesije says health protocols will be like manuals or books addressing current and emerging health issues, including new challenges in communicable disease prevention and control.
If effectively disseminated, these protocols will enhance the communication process and skills of our service providers.
These programs are expected to be launched by President Museveni on Tuesday in Kabuhei.